Well, good morning, everybody. Up at really stupid o'clock this morning. Got woke up at 5:50 this morning by Jack. So, Jock. So we've been out on a really good walk. It's now 8:30. We've been back for about an hour. It took me 10 minutes just to dry the mutt. It gets absolutely soaking wet just by rolling about in the wet grass. Anyway, here's classic Ericoze for you again. This is obviously just before Making a Murderer Series 2 came out, as you'll realize from his description and what he's talking about. So let's share screen. Make sure the sound's on. Yep, share that one. Yep, and share. And I think we're looking good. Dude's all ready to go, got him all lined up. So let's click on that. Let's go full screen. Yeah, let's click on. Oh my goodness, dude, you look very serious there. You know, he wasn't often serious, I can tell you that much. It was always good fun, always laughing.
Hello, folks. How you doing today? We're here today talking about, well, I guess you can probably see what we're talking about here on my shirt. Today we're talking about the Control Question t-shirts. They are available now. I've had a lot of many people asking me. Yes, they are available. I'm going to create a post on the Ericoze AMAM Facebook page, and you can go there. There will be a post, and then you can let me know where you live, and that will help in the calculation of postage. So, you can even give me, like, I don't know, a random address of some random business or bar or something near where you live. Just a whatever kind of token address for now, so that just for calculation of postage or whatever. So, anyways, so they're available. They're $15 each plus postage, and as I said, all of the profit from it goes to Brendan. Make sure you get one. I know. I hope. The whole idea here is that I would like for everybody that wants to be wearing their Brendan Dassey Control Question t-shirt on October 19th, his birthday, while they're watching MAM season 2. I want them to be able to have the shirt and do that, and to be able to do that if they want. So just letting everybody know that's available. So re now, one other thing that I've been doing recently, and been hoping more people would really catch on to it, was I've been making these videos about wrongful convictions of juveniles. Juveniles, people that were very young, got, gentlemen who were very young when they were convicted and eventually were exonerated because, well, what should have been obvious mishandling, somehow ends up always taking 15 or 20 years to figure out, which is more in the case of John Bunn. It took 28 years, but he was out on parole for part of that 28 years. But still took 28 years to iron it out. I've been creating these videos about these wrongfully convicted juveniles so that there's, like, more of an awareness. And so if any of you out there have an interest in that, and you didn't realize that I was making videos like that, you only have to look for the beginning acronym. It's WC, capital W, capital C, lowercase o, and a capital Y, and that basically just stands for wrongful convictions of youth. And I've done one. The first actually one I did was about Devante Sanford. That video is actually called The Innocence Deniers. I'll leave that link below for you guys to check out as well, along with the Facebook page. That was the first one I did. And it was named The Innocence Deniers. Very, very, just amazing story. Amazing in the sense of how they left this kid, convicted when they knew he didn't do it. And it's just a horrible story of a DA that is just a monster, in my opinion.
Him
So,
unworthy.
but there's that one. And then I did another one on a kid. Well, not a kid anymore, obviously, but a young man named Corey Williams. He was, wrongfully convicted at 16. And then I just recently did one about John Bunn, who was convicted at 14 years old of murder, and he only just recently in 2018 was finally exonerated when because his conviction had been overturned back in 2015, and the Brooklyn DA's office announced this year finally that they were not going to be pursuing, charges against John Bunn or his co-defendant, Rojan, I'm sorry, I forget his last name, but so I'll leave the link to all of those videos for those who are interested in that, in creating awareness of it. And please share them around where you think people might be interested. Just continuing to create that awareness of this is happening to more than one, more than two, more than three, and we'll see the list grow, of course. And the idea is to make it where eventually it becomes so manifest that it just can't be ignored anymore, right? So, and the more people that are out here like me calling attention to it, the better, of course. But if, I understand not everybody's willing to get on camera and do what I do, but the next best thing is sharing links for stuff like this so that other people can get aware and that sort of thing. So, now, one other thing I want to talk about before I get into the whole bit about why we're here today, which I haven't said yet, is Kathleen Zellner recently filed for an extension to file her motion with the appeals court regarding the CD and the whole computer thing and all that deal. So she asked for an extension. It was granted today. She now has till December 20th to file with the appeals court on that matter. So that's just letting everybody know that's where that's at right now, just real quick before we get into this. So, as it turns out now, the control question t-shirts, of course, are available and everything. So, today, our generous Australian benefactor, Mr. Mark Hodnott, decided that he wanted to donate two shirts for worthy, supporters, people that, have been, supporting for a long time, and I intend to have a very interesting way of deciding, how to hand these two t-shirts out. Well, the way that I think is probably the best way to do it is I'd like to see those who can write a comment below in the comments below the video here. Those who can write a comment where it basically outlines the control question, what happens with the control question, why the control question is important, and putting particular emphasis on the fact that when that Tom Fassbender originally asks him if it was there, and he says, and had he stopped there would have been nothing to talk about. But then he said, "Do you disagree with me?" To which Brendan reacts to the mental conditioning that he's been receiving the entire weekend and is afraid to be in disagreement with the investigator, which is clear from the entire interrogation, and immediately says no. Now, most people are saying, "Oh, it doesn't matter, it doesn't mean anything." Oh, it absolutely means something, because they're claiming this is proof of Brendan resisting when it's proof of the exact opposite thing, Brendan buckling under the pressure. So, hey, that type of stuff, that's what I'm looking for. Deep insight, so that I know if we give you the shirt, if we give you the shirt for free, I at least want to know that the person that it's going to is well versed and is going to be able to talk very intelligently about it, and you know what I mean? So that there's a certain worthiness to it, where I definitely do want the free shirts to go to two people that just understand and feel the passion about how ridiculous the control question is, and the way that the state and the on-bank majority have represented it as something as completely opposite of what it is. So those, I want to make sure it gets into the hands of those people. So I'm gonna go ahead and say we're gonna in the, when I post this video, we're gonna wait 3 days, and we're gonna wait and see all the comments that come in 3 days. And then Mr. Hodnott, Mr. Capaldi, the Mad Scotsman, and I
Who you
will
calling
have to go
mad?
through them over the weekend, most likely, and pick the best two. And then we'll figure out, you know, how to introduce ourselves and make sure we get the shirts to those two individuals. But that's later. So for those that want to get a free shirt, you know, I just want to make sure it's going to somebody who can really, you know, defend it and defend Brendan and talk about it and you know, just make it that much more of a useful tool helping Brendan to make other people aware of what's going on in our justice system. And as I said, with my Wrongful Conviction of Youth series, WCOY, it's not just Brendan. There's a lot more out there. It's you know, it's a problem that's crying out. And you know, we just got to keep pounding away at it and persevere. And eventually, the right people are going to come into power. The right people are going to be in the right positions at the right times to do the sensible thing. And eventually, things will start to move in the positive direction. And we will begin, I hope, to start to pull our criminal justice system kind of out of the dark ages when it comes to certain things like juvenile interrogations and even to some extent adult ones, to be perfectly honest. But the adult, you know, interrogations topic is a lot more thorny and has a lot more, you know, points where it that are just contestable. But with the juveniles, I think it's really kind of pretty clear and clean cut. They require special care. The Supreme Court has said it in numerous decisions that they require special care. And yeah, it's just that didn't happen with Brendan, and it didn't happen with a lot of these other cases that I've been covering on my channel as well. So, like I said, Devontae Sanford was the first one. I'll post the link below. Corey Williams was the second one. I'll post the link for that below. And then we have John Bunn, the most recent one, which I love because John Bunn turned a negative into a positive. He didn't let it beat him down. He didn't let it ruin his life. He made sure that he came out swinging. You know, when he finally got out and he finally got away from all that, he had given himself the tools to succeed. He had taught himself to read and write. He was educating himself the whole time he was in there, reading anything he could get his hands on. And he gave himself the tools to be able to get out of there and not end up in the cycle that most, you know, inmates get into, where they just get out and back in and get out and back in and get out and back in. You know, he didn't that he got out of that. He now runs an organization that gives that donates books to many of the detention centers over in Brooklyn and over in the New York area there. And he's growing his little nonprofit. It's called Voices for the Unheard. So I can't say enough about the guy because I was so darn impressed. Just so darn impressed with the guy that I just can't say enough about him. I can't sing his praises enough. He really is a shining example of the what the human spirit and the perseverance that it's capable of. You know, John Bunn embodies that. And my hat's off to him. So just wanted to go ahead and talk about that because hey, look, it's not just Brendan out there, folks. Anyways, now, so like I said, over the weekend, most likely, Mark Hodnott and Paul Capaldi and I will go over the comments that have come in on that 3-day period, and we will pick two. Anyway, this was just a little fun idea that I thought was cool. Mr. Hodnott, of course, being the generous, you know, donor here, and providing two shirts to give away, and most likely, maybe in a week or so, you know, there'll probably be another, you know, two shirts available for some kind of a contest again or something, so that some people out there that might not have a whole lot of cash but a whole lot of knowledge can maybe get themselves a t-shirt. So that's what I'm hoping anyways. So anyways, that's about it for this one, folks. Remember Brendan Dassey? Remember, you know, Stephen, obviously the new the just be patient. Kathleen Zellner filed for an extension. The new date is moved now over to December 20th. That her filing will be due with the Court of Appeals. So, just because I know a lot of people out there miss these little things like when it gets extended and when it, you know, I know it's kind of crazy, you know, the whole process. You got to follow it kind of closely to kind of understand it. You know, there is a method to the madness in it all, really. I know it's hard to believe, but there is. So anyways, that's about it, folks. Like I said, leave your comments below explaining why the control question is so important and how you would defend Brendan Dassey if somebody came up and asks you about the control question, as your t-shirt will be suggesting that they do. So that's about it for today, folks. If you haven't already, please hit subscribe, and we'll see you.
What a great response we had to that. We had loads to go through. The dude sent me a load, and I think I was checking out what was going on anyway. Also, what was... doesn't know what buttons to press. Sorry about that. The response was tremendous. We had absolutely superb answers. But in the end, I'm absolutely sure that we were in agreement with our top two. If I remember rightly, and I must check this out, we went for one that was very, very brief and to the point. Was absolutely, you know, something that you know that somebody could explain to somebody in a relatively small amount of time, and then we had a much longer in-depth look at it. I mean, it's just a great conversation starter. I must know I've had people ask me about it. A lot of people, of course, recognize the name Brendan Dassey, and they often ask me, you know, what's the latest with Brendan Dassey? Is he free yet? Unfortunately not, but the way Zelna's going, it won't be long before Steve's out, and then Brendan can just start packing his bags as well. Just to mention, many thanks to Alice yesterday for joining us. Really enjoyed the chat with the Ouijis. We love the glass Ouijans. Great sense of humor. Loved her answer to Still Game or Rabsy Nesbitt. There's only one Rabsy Nesbitt. Absolutely brilliant. So looking forward to tonight, my time. Deeply honored to have a Jack61 join me for a chat. Never had a chat with Jack before. I've seen him on various videos before, obviously. But to actually have him live on the show will be great. And of course, tomorrow, Saturday, the Moose live, 2 o'clock Wisconsin time, with a few guests. We'll have a few shits and giggles, as he calls them. It'll be great to have Pete and some guests to chat. I think that'll do fine for today. I better crack on. No peace for the wicked, as they say. So we'll see you all just over 13 hours time from now. Yeah, 13 hours and 10 minutes from now will be my 10 o'clock. That's 4 o'clock for Jack 61. Really looking forward to that. And then the Moose on Saturday. Catch you soon. Bye for now.